हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग. वेलकम टू लेक्चर नंबर 4 वीडियो. इन टुडेज क्लास आई कंटिन्यू द सेम टॉपिक नेम्ड फीचर्स ऑफ कंप्यूटर्स. इन द लास्ट क्लास ऑलरेडी आई स्टार्टेड दिस टॉपिक बट आई वॉज नॉट एबल टू कंप्लीट. In today's class, I complete this topic for you. Why the computer systems have become so popular today? Because of some good characteristics like all the machines will work with very high speed. That means machines will give us the result in less time. That's why machines have become so popular. Because all the machines will work with very high speed. That is what we discussed in the last class in detail. In the last class, I told you that machines are having the capability to execute millions of instructions per second. That is what we measure the speed of computers in terms of megahertz. Not only millions of instructions per second, machines are having the capability to execute billions of instructions per second also. That is what the speed is measured in terms of gigahertz. 1 second is further divided into 1000 times, that is what, milliseconds. If you divide that 1 into 6 times, that is microseconds. 9 times nanoseconds. 12 times picoseconds. Computer is fast electronic device. It is having the capability to solve large and complex problem in fraction of second. That's why computers have become so popular. That is what we studied in the last class. Now I explain you other good characteristics of a computer system. Computer systems have become so popular. Why do you know? Not only because of speed, computer systems are having high storage capacity. Means we can store huge amount of data. We can store huge amount of data where? In computer's secondary memory. In computer's secondary memory. For further or future use. Once you store the data inside the secondary memory, data will be in the memory only till we delete it. Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes, that is what the advantage of using computer. We can store huge amount of data. Okay, no problem at all. That's why computers have become so popular. Then how that data will be stored in memory? One small discussion we do on that. Machines have become so popular because of high storage capacity. Just only I explained to you. We discuss one more small topic here that is really important. What is the unit of computer's memory? I hope you might be knowing. Computer's memory is measured in terms of bytes or bits. Already we know what bit stands for. Binary digit. Bits means binary digits. Bits means binary digits like zeros and ones. Machine understands only zeros and ones. Zeros and ones are called binary डिजिट्स, बाइनरी नंबर्स और डिजिट्स. माई क्वेश्चन इज दैट रियली दैट मशीन विल आइडेंटिफाई द नंबर जीरो और वन. नो. इफ यू शो जीरो टू ए कंप्यूटर सिस्टम whether the machine will identify the zero? No. If you show the number 1 to the computer system, machine will identify it? No. Then what do you mean by zero for computer? What do you mean by 1 for computer? I am asking this question to one of the student. One of the student is telling the answer to me like this. Dear sir, zero means false. One means true. My question to you is that whether really that machine will understand the word like false or true? No. I am asking the same question to another student. Dear second student, can you tell me what do you mean by zero? Sir, zero means no. One means yes. That means machine will identify yes or no? No. Then what do you mean by zero? Sir, zero means off. One means on. That means you are telling like that machine will understand the word like off and on? No. Then what the machine will understand? What do you mean by zero? Yeah, correct. I explain. Zero means absence of something. One means presence of something. All of you are present inside the class now. All of you are equivalent to one presence. The students who are absent for today's class, all those students are equivalent to zero. Which one is present? That is one. Which one is not present? That is zero. Okay, I explain more. Absence means that might be absence of voltage. Absence of voltage is nothing but zero for computer. Assume zero voltage. Presence of some voltage like plus 5 voltage is nothing but 1 for computer. Not only absence of voltage and presence of voltage, unmarked area on CD. Marked area on CD means we have not done any marking on CD, means that is 0. If you do one type of marking with the help of laser beam, then that is called as 1. On disk, I will show you the disk here. This is what the secondary memory hard disk. Here you can see the disk. On this disk, we find n number of tracks will be here. Tracks. On this entire disk, aluminium coat will be there. You can see this diagram. This is what the disk. Okay. And you can find the layer here. This is the aluminium layer. Okay. Material will be there. You can see the laser beams here. Laser. This laser, with the help of laser beam, we write the data there and sensors will read it. You can see here aluminium data layer. Aluminium data layer. Okay. And here what? You can see the marking, okay, laser beam, pit and land. Land means you can see here zero, means we are not at all marked. This is unmarked area. This is unmarked area. Wherever the one will come, there we are marking. Wherever the one will come, there we are marking. Different types of encoding decoding techniques are there. Means unmarked area is zero, one is marked area. That much you remember, it is more than sufficient now. You can see here, this is the top view of a disk. You can see some marked area. Can you see these marked areas now? Remaining is unmarked area. Marked area is 1, unmarked area is 0. Okay, no problem. Little bit, I think you have understood. I explain little bit in depth so that you can understand. Like this, on disk, magnetic particles will be there. if that particle is magnetized one, that is one formation, which is not yet magnetized, that is demagnetized particle is zero. That is what the machine can understand. Usually whenever anybody will ask you the question like what is the language known by machine, what the machine can understand, everyone will tell that machine will understand zeros and ones. That is true also, but in reality machine will not identify the number 0 and 1. 0 for computer system means absence of voltage, unmarked area on CD, demagnetized particle on CD. That is what the 0 for machine. Not only these encoding techniques, other encoding techniques are there. In higher semester, if you belongs to CS, IS, AI and ML, you learn in detail, no need to worry. Now as a bird's view, as a fundamental, I am teaching. That is what the basics of computer. Presence means presence of something is one for machine. Presence of voltage is one for machine. That is plus 5 voltage is there. Marked area on CD with help of laser beam is one for machine. Magnetized particle from the CD can be assumed as one. I hope little bit now you gain the knowledge what the machine can understand. Absence of something is zero for machine. Presence of something is one for machine. I give a very interesting example so that you can understand. Now for example, if I store the letter A, capital A, if I store the letter capital A, how the letter A will be stored in the CD or in secondary memory? Letter A will be stored as it is? No. In reality, for a computer system, capital A means 65. What is this, sir? No, I explained, don't worry. For a computer system, A means 65. B means 66, C means 67. Now can you tell me D means 68? Like this it continues up to capital Z, 90. Capital A means 65 for machine, computer system. Capital B means 66 for computer system. Capital C means 67. Small A means 97. Sir, what are these? You can ask me question. 65, 66, you are telling. No, sir, what are these? These are all ASCII values. ASCII. Sir, what is ASCII? AS stands for American, S stands for standard, C for code. ASC. American standard code. AS stands for American standard code for information interchange. In order to interchange the information with computer system, Americans made some codes. Those are called ASCII values. American standard code for machine. Now, sir, you are telling that machine knows only zeros and ones, but capital A for machine means 65. Then how the machine 65? Machine is going to understand. No, machine will not understand 65. 65 we have to convert into zeros and ones. How to convert 65 into zeros and ones? See here. If you want to convert 65 into zeros and ones, you have to divide that number by 2. 2 threes are 6. 2 twos are 4. Remainder is 1. Okay, sir. Next 2 ones are 2. 2 sixes are 12. Remainder is 0. 2 eights are 16. Remainder is 0. 2 4s are 8, remainder is 0. 2 2s are 4, remainder is 0. 2 1s are 2, remainder is 0. Last one is important. 2 0s are 0. 2 0s are 0. Then remainder is how much? 1. 2 0s are 0, remainder is 1. Okay. Now what you need to do, note down these zeros and ones from bottom to top. 1 0 0 0 0 0 1. This is what the binary equivalent of the number 65 or the binary equivalent of the capital letter A. See here, 1 5 times 0 1. This is binary. Base is 2. Base is 10 here. in our everyday routine life, we use decimal number system. Decimal number system is 10 symbols we use. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10 symbols. But in binary number system, we use only 2 symbols. Zeros and ones. That's our base is 2. That means capital A will be stored like this on CD or DVD or any of the disk. This is called machine language. This A is called as high level language. I hope little bit you understood. Which one is high level here? Which one is high level? A. This is high level language. High level language is A. Then which one is the machine level language here? Machine equivalent. Which one is the machine level language here? Can you tell me? Yeah, very good. This is what the machine can understand. Means machine understands only zeros and ones. That means my letter A has been stored like this inside the computer's memory. We type WhatsApp message, then we send to our friend or to the relative or to the friend. No, that typed message is having for every character, for every symbol, one ASCII value will be there. That we converted into zeros and ones. Zeros and ones will be transmitted through the different medias. While entering into the friend's phone, again that machine language will be converted into high level language. Hello my dear friends, very good morning to you all. Wish you happy new year. Wish you happy Deepavali. We send the messages, no? How that transmission takes place? We type the message in high level language. Conversion takes place into machine level language. That data will be transmitted via different media. While entering into that one, again that will be converted into high level language. There is a need of one converter who can convert it from high level to machine as well as machine level to high level. That is called as translator, who translates the language from one to another. I hope little bit you are understanding the things. Oh, very good. Keep it up. To get the binary equivalent of 65, we need to divide the number 65 by 2 and note down reminders from bottom to top. Okay, I have written everything clearly. Like this only, for a computer system, we press enter key, no? How the computer will come to know that you pressed enter key? For enter key, ASCII value is 13. From keyboard, we press escape key. How the machine will come to know that you pressed escape key? For escape key, 27. I will show you the ASCII chart here. Can you see the ASCII table? You can search in Google search engine. See here, these are the decimal values. Okay, these are hexadecimal. In hexadecimal, we use 16 symbols. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C, D, E, F, 10. Okay, no problem. Now, see here. Where is A? See here, A. Where is A? Oh, sorry. A means what? 65. Where is 65? Here. 65 means what for machine? Capital A. 66 means what? B. 67 means what? C. See here. Up to Z, 90. 91 is for opening square bracket. 92 is for backslash. 93 is for closing square bracket. 94 is for caret symbol. And 95 is for other underscore mostly. 96 for 60, single quote. 97 onwards, small A starts. How the machine will come to know that you pressed that only? If you press space bar, 32. Is the ASCII value. In decimal ASCII value is 32, in hexadecimal 20. In interview they are going to ask you, dear student, can you tell me the ASCII value of capital A in decimal? Sir, 65. Can you tell me the ASCII value of A in hexadecimal? 41. Oh, like this sir, machine works. Yeah, this is what American Standard Code for Information Interchange Table. I hope you understood. Note down reminders from bottom to top. Like this we get. That means this is what the machine can understand. Like this the data will be stored. Like this we can store huge amount of data. Sir, you are telling huge amount of data, how much of data? Okay, I explain. I continue the topic. Another 5 minutes I complete the class. Now byte. Actually, to store one character, in computer's memory, machine uses 1 byte. Oh ho, to store one character, very interesting. To store one character, machine uses 1 byte. One character means 1 byte. Okay, 1 byte means 8 bits. 1 byte means 8 bits, 8 binary digits. That means if you combine zeros and ones 8 times, zeros and ones 8 times, any combination, this is equal to 1 byte. Okay, if you combine zeros and ones 8 times, that is called 1 byte. 0 0 0 0 0, this is 1 byte. Getting all of you? Now A means 0 1 0 0 0 0 0 1, this is what 1 byte. To store one character in memory, machine uses 1 byte. If you combine zeros and ones only 4 times, that is called as one nibble. One nibble means how many bits? 4 bits. 8 bits means 1 byte. How the word byte has been formed? Say continuously by eight, by eight, by eight, by eight, it becomes byte. Means we combine zeros and ones for how many times? 8 times. That is 8 binary digits is equivalent to 1 byte. Like that, 1024 characters we can store. That means 1024 bytes we need. 1024 bytes means 1 kilobyte. If the computer's memory is 1 kilobyte, we can store 1024 bytes. Like that, 1024 kilobytes means 1 megabyte. Oh, 1024 megabyte means 1 gigabyte. 1024 gigabyte means 1 terabyte. 1024 terabyte means 1 petabyte. This continues. Nowadays, we are getting the hard disk in terms of terabyte. It is more than sufficient to store huge amount of data in memory. This is what all about the high storage capacity, as well as I told you byte, bit, high level language, machine level language. This is what all about today's lecture number 4. In the next lecture video, I teach you accuracy, computer program, all these things I teach you in the next class. Please, till then, take care. Have a nice day. If you have any doubts, please ask me questions. I am ready to help. Okay? Thank you, one and all.